I'm gonna share 11 Hermès lipsticks with you and show you how they look on me. Are they really worth it? I'll share my thoughts in the end. I'll also link all the links and the color details in the description box down below for you. Leave me a comment down below to let me know which color is your favorite and do you think that they're worth it? Let's get right into the video. Let's start with the Rouge Amazon in the satin finish. It's a warm-toned brick red inspired by the ceremonial harnesses created by Hermès in 1894 for the White House of the Chinese Empress Cixi. I love the rich texture. The satin finish gives a red a beautiful shine on top. If you need anything to brighten up your look, this is definitely a very vibrant shade of true red. It feels feminine, beautiful, mature for any different occasions from happy hour to day night. This one is Rouge Exotic in the matte finish. It's such a lively, luminous Rouge Exotic color. It has the radiance of a freshly squeezed pomegranate, orange with a hint of pink. If you love a bit orange red, this is the perfect one for you. Although it's in the matte finish, it feels very hydrating, velvety, and powdery. It's such a fun and playful lipstick for you to make a statement. This one is the Poppy Lip Shine that elegantly enhances and amplifies the natural radiance of the lips. A translucent, slightly orange-toned formula enriched with mother of pearl microparticles. It has a fine, rich, and a comfortable texture. I really love the iridescent mother of pearl shine, and you can wear it alone or layer it with other lipstick to have the glitter finish on top. Lip Enhancer is very similar to Chapstick, and the difference is that Lip Enhancer has a more matte and a waxy finish. It's really easy to put it on and you don't need to be so precise. Rose Tan is an amber-toned warm color, just like the imprint of the sun on the lips. Its weightless and translucent halo reveals the lip's natural beauty. I really enjoy the fine and delicate waxy finish. The Rose Lip Enhancer melts over the lips, leaves a hint of transparent pink and a matte luminosity. Your lips are delicately smooth with their soft focus effect after each use. The sesame seed and the raspberry seed oils in the ingredients help to soften and nourish your lips every time. This one is the Rose Apis color in satin finish. This color invokes sensual new horizons, spicy and fragrant, with the natural tones of terracotta. It's just such a feminine and beautiful everyday color with rich and a fine texture. This one is the Orange Broad color in the satin finish. The Orange Broad color is the dynamic color of Hermès's signature box since 1942. It's just so Hermès, and I didn't think orange would suit me, but it looked surprisingly good after I put it on. By the way, my sales associate also mentioned that this is one of the most popular colors they have been selling. What do you think of this orange color? This is the Rouge Age in the matte finish. It's an emblematic color of the House of Hermes. It's a very elegant dark red with a hint of brown, verging on burgundy. If you're looking for a dark red, this is the perfect shade for you. It feels a little wicked, mature, yet still really, really beautiful. This one is the famous Rouge Cossack in the matte finish. It's such a characterful, dense, and radiant red. It reminded me so much of their Rouge Cossack bags. If you're looking for a true red shade, and this is the perfect one for you. Remember the orange broad color that I had in the satin finish earlier? This one is the orange color in the matte finish. The orange color is indeed a dynamic color of the Hermes signature box color since 1942. It's a very comfortable, hydrating matte lipstick. Like my essay mentioned, the orange color is one of the best sellers for them. For the same orange color, if I have to choose between the satin and the matte, I think I like the matte finish a bit more. How about you? This one is the beige Tadlock in the satin finish. It's a color inspired by the radiance of the Berber House. It's a beige with a soft, sunny, and orange glow. It's super easy to apply and I love the rich texture. This one is a perfect everyday color that you can wear in so many different occasions. It makes me feel really feminine and pretty. This is the Rose Encens in the satin finish. It's a smoky gray-toned pink, both soft and intense, as silky as Hermes' beloved India scarf. I love the satin finish in a way it's very similar to the beige Tadlock, yet still very different. It's one of the perfect colors that you can wear on a daily basis. So most of the Hermes lipsticks are retailing for $67. They're a few dollars more for the limited edition. Of course that the lipsticks itself, really nothing special formula or anything compared to many other luxury brands, and it's a little bit on the pricey side, but however, it's Hermes. It feels really nice packaging and it feels super luxurious, and it's something really nice to have in your bag that you can carry around with you, use on a daily basis, make you feel really good. The other thing is that if you do pick up these lipsticks for your quota bags, it does count toward your spending. Compared to many other purchases, this is not expensive at all. It diversifies your profile. It shows that as a customer, besides other things, that you're interested in other things from Hermes, like their makeup, if you are working toward your quota bags. So to me, it's worth it. especially I'm purchasing all these lipsticks to do this video for you guys. After you use up the lipstick, you can also purchase refill instead of getting a new lipstick tube. And I think the refill is more affordable. So to me, it's worth it. Leave me a comment down below to let me know what you think and which color is your favorite. And I'll see you soon. Bye bye!